Brother?
No, you can't tie it around my neck. Hey, we're gonna do the end of World War One and post-war, okay? Tomorrow we will review. Wednesday, they will take a test. Thursday will be your test, obviously, okay? All right, here we go. In August of 1918, the Allied commanders on the Western Front decided to go on the offensive. Okay, that's the Allies. That's who we consider the good guys. Okay, starting on August the 8th, a series of battles were fought, and they were called. That was called the 100 Days Offensive. Okay, these battles included the Battle of Amiens, the Second Battle of Somme, several battles along Germany-Hindenburg line. The Germans were pushed out of France back into Germany. They were forced to retreat back into Germany at this point in time. So the war is coming to an end. Germany is pretty basically defeated. By the end of the 100-day offense, the German forces were exhausted and running out of food and supplies.
Oh, no.
On November the 11th, 1918, they request amnesty, okay, or an armistice. And that is when, of course, both sides agrees to stop fighting while a peace treaty is being negotiated. Okay. The Allies agreed to this at 11 a.m. on November the 11th, 1918, the fighting in World War One ends.
I want y'all to see something here. We have two supposedly friends. One of them is throwing stuff at them, messing up the, sit down, Seth.
The other one
is kicking over her water bottle. But what they're not doing is paying any attention to what's going on in class. And now it's on tape so that their parents can see it.
Email their parents to watch the video.
All right. Nope, but if a question comes up, that doesn't go away. All right. Anybody else know what November the 11th is? What is November the 11th?
3 days before my birthday.
It is
Veterans
Day. Veterans Day.
Yeah, because I remember reading
it. It becomes Veterans Day later on.
And then they made it.
All right. If you're talking and not paying any attention, right there's the door. I'll come get you at the end of class. Yeah, no one was talking. I could hear myself over them, but no one was talking.
Watch the replay.
Well, since none of you were talking, we won't have that problem again, will we? All right, treaty negotiations. The Allied nations met in Paris at the Paris Peace Conference in 1919 to decide the fate of Germany and the Central Powers. Although a number of nations took part in the negotiation, the major decisions and the discussions between the leaders of the what they considered the Big Four nations, okay, and that, of course, was France, Great Britain,
United States,
and Italy, okay? That was, Germany was a bad guy. They're discussing the fate of Germany. Okay. Yeah. No, if you lose, you don't get to negotiate anything. You pretty much are at the mercy of whoever is negotiating. Yeah. So that's the four. So the four leaders from those countries, along with others, meet, but that is the big four right there. Okay? Each of the four nations had different opinions on how Germany should be treated. President Woodrow Wilson felt that the best solution was to incorporate his 14 points. Okay? He thought that Germany should not be blamed for the war or punished too harshly. However, the French Prime Minister,
who had been in the war longer,
yep, felt that Germany was responsible for the war and should take the blame and have to pay big for it.
Okay? Big money.
But the French
were not just money. It wasn't just, it's not just money that they hit them with. Okay?
They dug like 442
And it is a, they take land, they reduce their military, they do a lot of stuff, okay? The Treaty of Versailles was signed between the Allied powers and Germany on June 28, 1919. So that officially ended World War I. The treaty was extremely harsh on Germany. Okay, and we've talked about this before. In fact, it was so harsh between this treaty and then the Great Depression's creeping in a few years later, that actually, it was like the perfect storm that led
Hitler
being able to rise up in power, which, of course, causes World War. It causes Hitler to be able to rise into power that begins World War II, of course. So this does play into that. All of it kind of plays into it. Okay? So it forced Germany to accept responsibility for causing all of the loss and damage of the war. Yeah, that might have been a little harsh. They were forced to disarm, which means basically their military was cut down to just enough personnel and weaponry to protect their borders. They not enough that they would ever be able to attack anyone else, okay? No planes, no ships, no tanks. I mean, it was pretty basically rifles, bayonets, hand grenades, and just a handful of personnel compared to what they had.
But in that time, they figured out a lot of things about
war. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Too many bad things.
Okay. They were also forced to give up land. Okay. And they had to pay 132 billion marks, which in 2014 would have been somewhere around $442 billion.
That's a lot of money.
That's a lot of money for a nation that is already struggling economically because they lost the war. Yes.
So they agreed to sign.
Brock and Holden, please act like you have just a little bit of sense.
So they agreed to, they agreed on the armistice on November 11th, 1918.
Yep.
But they didn't actually sign
it
until June
28th. Yeah, it took about 7 months to get around to actually signing the treaty. But no war was going on. I mean, the fighting had ended. But I guarantee you, up until 11 a.m. on November the 11th, fighting was taking place. I don't know why in the world, but that's
I think that's because they wanted to get much more land possible.
You already lost the war, though. You've accepted the fact that you've lost, but yet you fight right up until
it starts.
I don't know. We've always done that. All right, new nation borders. The map of Europe changed significantly after World War I. Several new independent countries were formed, including Poland, Finland, Yugoslavia, Czechoslovakia, Russia became the Soviet Union, and the Ottoman Empire later becomes the country of Turkey. Okay? And Germany also had to give up provinces to France, okay? So Germany lost quite a bit of land, which is in World War II, which is why the first thing they do is invade Poland, because they're going back after, they want their land back, you know, truthfully.
Wait, did Germany own Poland, like?
Yeah, it was part of.
Germany.
We'll pull up a, remind me tomorrow, we'll pull up a World War II map
be a lot
before
bigger.
And after the war.
Yeah,
Germany got there. Germany got cut down quite a bit.
So they wanted land, but they lost it.
Texas is way bigger.
Yeah, they wanted land, they lost land. Lost land, lost money, lost lives. It was a pretty thorough defeat for them. As part of the Paris Peace Conference, an organization called the League of Nations was formed. The League of Nations was formed in an effort to establish world peace. On paper, this looks great, okay? Mm-hmm. Its member countries hoped to prevent war by helping settle disputes between countries. The League also aimed to establish fair labor conditions, improve global health, control the global arms trade, and protect minorities in Europe. Okay? The League was officially founded by the Treaty of Versailles and had 42 founding member countries. Okay? One of them was not the United States, oddly enough. Okay? It was our president's idea, but the United States did not join the League of Nations. Okay?
No, is the League of Nations not
the UK
or something?
Was it his idea?
No, it's the League of Nations. United Nations.
Wasn't it his idea for the League of Nations?
Yes, it was, but Congress didn't think it was a good idea and did not join. And as it turns out, it really wasn't. I mean, it's back again. As an old basketball coach, you know, I have sat down before and drawn up these plays
that
on paper, you're like, baby, this is unstoppable. No one is going to be able to defend against this because it doesn't work. Once you put it on the floor and you get people trying to do it, you're like, okay, no, this is not going to work at all. But it looked great on paper. Looked great on paper. Okay? So that's kind of the way this was. It looked really good on paper. I mean, the thought behind it was excellent. Never will be another war. Minorities was going to be protected. I mean, the idea behind it was fantastic. It really was. Just, you throw in the human equation of greed and corruption and things of that nature, and it's not going to work. Yeah. Okay? All right. Interesting facts about the end of World War I. The United States did not sign the Treaty of Versailles, but established its own treaty with Germany.
Do you know what that was?
I don't remember the name of it, to be honest with you. Because the biggie was the one that they signed with the other ones.
Do you know what it did, what the treaty did?
It just said that we won't continue to fight Germany and they will not fight us.
Okay.
That's all. I mean, it's pretty simple. We did not. Wilson didn't sign. We want to sign the other one because he did not want to put all of those demands on Germany. So the one that we signed with them put no demands on them. But it didn't matter. They still had to sign the other one with Britain and France and all those.
They just
ones.
Didn't have to have extra.
Exactly. We just didn't throw anything extra on them. Mm-hmm. Yep. The United States also did not join the League of Nations, which was introduced by the U.S. President in his 14-point plan. Okay. The reparations that Germany owed from the treaty were renegotiated several times because, understand, they lost the war already. Their economy is in the toilet, so to speak. And here we are trying to make them pay all this money. They don't have this money to pay. So they renegotiate, and they finally get around. They renegotiate it several times and get it down. They finally get it paid off after World War II has ended. Okay? So, yeah.
What about World War II? Did Germany have to do anything after World War II?
No. Germany was pretty thoroughly defeated, and they were taken over by that point in time. Russia takes over half of them, and the rest of us takes over the other half.
Oh, yeah, East and West Germany.
Yeah, it becomes East and West Germany. So, I mean, the World War II, they were soundly. They're worse off than they were.
Everyone just slobbered.
And four European empires disappear after World War I, including the German, the Russian, Ottoman, and the Austria-Hungary Empire. Now, those are there. I mean, Germany doesn't go away, but the German Empire is not up and running like it was, okay? All right. 14 minutes this time. All right, talk to y'all later.